when I think about being positive and I really think about it, it permeates everything you do. So it permeates your teams, your clients, your solutions, the user experience you might be trying to create, customer experience. It just permeates everything. You can hear a smile in someone's voice when they're excited about the solution that they're inventing, when they're excited about the problem that they're solving, when they're excited about their team that's actually being successful and their colleagues who advance. If you can get to a stage where you're consistently positive and it's half full, not half empty, you're just in that much stronger position to influence others.
When I'm faced with some type of situation that I can't resolve or it's overwhelming, what I do is I try to take the negativity out of that issue or situation and try to reflect on the positive aspects of that. When you remove the negativity, you can think clearer, you can come up with a solution, and you can achieve your goals. When you're faced with something where you're not feeling you can go forward, you've hit a brick wall, take a break. Step away from the situation. I tend to go for a walk in the building, and I come back to my office, and I feel reinvigorated, and I can make a decision.
There's no straight line, right? There's ups and downs, twists and turns, and keeping an open mind of what opportunities may be there for you. You could plan all you want. Like they're saying, life happens when you're making other plans. And you could plan all you want, but in the end of the day, you have to believe in yourself and be open-minded to what the universe is presenting to you. Don't put all your emotional energy into one place, because you can have a portfolio of happiness in your life, or so many things can bring you joy that you could put energy towards, and to allow that to be how you spend your time. So when things get rough, there's other aspects of your life to go to for support to get back on track.
Any time in life, in work and personal life, things will challenge us. And instead of adopting the mindset of I have to do this, it's I get to do this. I get this really cool opportunity to do something that can make a difference. And that's really my goal every day, is to empower people on my team and to empower others to get outside of their comfort zone and achieve things that they didn't maybe think were possible. And I think having that empowerment and that positive attitude really changes the game for people around you and gives them the confidence as well.
My role is really around introducing change into an organization, which can be quite challenging and can be grueling. So I have to constantly remind myself that, first of all, change doesn't happen overnight. So that's the first thing, is staying patient. The second thing is I really thrive on building personal relationships. So particularly when I've had a tough meeting or tough day, I do like to walk around and talk to team members and say, let's go for coffee or let's go for a walk, and really continue to build those personal connections. And then third, I really try to go home at a good time so I can spend time with my kids. My kids, just like all kids, really embody perseverance and resilience. So it's just a constant reminder for me to keep going, even when the going gets tough.